Today we're talking about RS-485 design with Sandy in the NVE Application Center. Sandy, give us the 411 on 485 to avoid a bus 911.
Sure. RS-485 is a bidirectional, half-duplex transmission system, so data can be transmitted in both directions, but only one direction at a time. RS-485 allows up to 32 unit loads, although high fan-out transceivers like the NVE IR-3285 allow up to 256. Transceivers connect the nodes. Pull-up and pull-down resistors can make the network fail-safe. Several bus configurations are possible. These configurations have long stubs that can cause reflections. C and D are ideal because the nodes are in a continuous line, although not necessarily straight. Short spurs to intermediate nodes are often necessary. If so, stub lengths should be less than 1/6 of the electrical signal length. This is the formula for electrical signal length. Using typical values of 10 nanoseconds rise time and 78% propagation velocity, we get an electrical signal length of 2.3 meters. So the maximum stub length is 1/6 of the electrical length, or 39 centimeters.
And how long can we have the main bus?
Well, the longer the cable, the slower the data rate. RS-485 can transmit over 1200 meters, or 10 megabits per second, but not both. This graph shows the typical trade-off, depending on noise and jitter tolerance.
What about terminating lines?
Good point. Unterminated lines are only suitable for very low data rates and very short cables, otherwise reflections cause errors. Both ends of the bus, but not every node, should be terminated. Finally, for a fail-safe configuration, BIOS for at least 200 millivolts with no active drivers. This ensures the bus will be in a known state.
Don't forget about isolation.
Isolation reduces noise, eliminates ground loops, and improves safety. Isoloop isolators are faster, more reliable, and simpler than optocouplers. Here's an opto isolation board full of components.
That's a lot of parts.
Right. But isoloop isolators provide a single chip solution, combining isolation with communication functions. There's a full line of isolated transceivers, including the workhorse IL-485, the high-speed IR-3585, the fractional load IR-3285, and the low-cost IR-3185. There are 16-pin, wide-body SOICs and ultra-miniature, narrow-body parts. So let's sum up with my RS-485 tips. Keep stubs short. Use twisted pair cable. Shielding for long or fast buses. Ground one end of the shield. Terminate bus ends. BIOS for fail-safe. And, of course, use isolators.
Thanks, Sandy. Where can viewers go for more info?
You can click to go to the RS-485 Application Center at nve.com. Or call us at 800-GMR-7141, extension 4.